Welcome back to Good Day Las Vegas. Metro Sheriff Joe Lombardo joining us once again for our Morning Cup of Joe segment. Sheriff, good to see you again.
Morning. Good to see you, John.
All right, so Metro Sheriff, let's talk about 1 October. It's coming up just in a couple of weeks. We're 3 years since the tragedy on the Las Vegas Strip. Let's talk about what Metro was doing with the rest of Clark County on a remembrance ceremony. We know it's going to be different because of the pandemic. What are the plans right now?
As we speak today, they're going to have a small ceremony at the in the Clark County Government Center, their amphitheater, outdoor amphitheater area there. They're going to have some invited guests. I don't know who that would be, but in particular, probably some family members. There will be a single singer to sing the national anthem, more than likely. And then we'll have a small honor guard contingent present to honor the event. And then we'll have some dignitaries provide some speeches. I believe the governor and a couple other folks, including myself, will be present.
In the last couple of years when I've been out there, a lot of survivors go to the amphitheater for the morning event in particular. Do you know if they're going to be allowed to go, if they're going to be able to be outside and see the events?
Yeah, they will be, but you know, there'll be a limitation of 50 people in that amphitheater area. The county is going to open up their emergency management room area within the building to include an additional 50 people. So maximum 100 people, and the county is going to be the triage on that to decide who's going to be able to physically attend the event.
Let's also talk about some other things that have been going on around the country. We've talked about the unrest in other parts of the U.S. We've seen that earlier in the summer, of course, the protests in downtown Las Vegas, Black Lives Matter after the death of George Floyd. Is there any sort of changes, I guess, when it comes to police response, police reform, other things that these protests are trying to get changed that Metro is using to move forward? How can these cities and police departments move forward from some of the unrest, some of the concerns, and some of the protests?
Well, you got to understand why they're protesting, first and foremost. People are frustrated. They think there's systemic racism that's in society, and police are the perpetrators of that racism. And police departments in general need to open their eyes and realize that reform is needed. When you look at locally here compared to what's going on in the rest of the nation and the type of protests and the chaos, such as Portland, as compared to here, is I think there's a different way of doing business here in Las Vegas. And first and foremost is transparency. The public wanted to hear the details. They wanted to know what took place, and they wanted to know that if the officers have committed wrongdoing, that they're being held accountable. And so we realized that. We put the system in place. Now it's considered best practice what we do here at Las Vegas Metro. And I think that's some of the failure you've seen in the other jurisdictions with the individuals that lost their lives to police action. I believe there is issues in police work, and we have been slow to change. I think a lot of police heads of agency are aware of these issues, underlying issues, but police culture is hard to change, and we have been slow to change.
Sheriff, thank you very much for joining us once again this morning and chatting with us about what's happening in law enforcement in the Valley. If you at home have a question for Sheriff Lombardo, you could submit it at 8newsnow.com. Find out if your question is answered every Wednesday.